everyone, welcome to the third video of class 7th history lesson 5, rulers and buildings. But do you know, children, the kings used to fight lots and lots of wars, and after a war would be over, the winning king used to destroy the temples constructed by the losing king. You know why? Because the temples represented power, wealth and devotion of a king. So the winning king, in order to show that the losing king is very weak, used to destroy temples constructed by them, and they even used to plunder all the wealth that the kings used to hide in their temples. Now let's discuss examples of some kings who attacked temples. First example is of Pandyan king Srimara Srivallabha. He invaded Sri Lanka, and there he defeated the Sri Lankan king Sena I, and he seized lots and lots of valuables from there. A very important item was a statue of Buddha that was made up of gold. He took it to India. Then after some years, the ruler in Sri Lanka changed, and the new ruler was Sena II. Sena II was the nephew of Sena I. So Sena II sent his general to India, and there he defeated the Pandyan king Srimara Srivallabha and brought the gold statue of Buddha back to Sri Lanka. All this was noted by Buddhist chronicler Dhammakirti, and Sri Lankan ruler is also referred to as Sinhalese ruler in the book, because Sinhala was and is the main language of Sri Lanka. Next example is of Sultan Mahmud of Ghazni. He came from Ghazni, which is in Afghanistan, and he came to India, and he looted and attacked lots of temples in India. One very important temple was Somnath temple in Gujarat that he looted. Then another example is of Chola king Rajendra I, who built the Shiva temple, and he filled that temple with seized statues. So some statues that were seized and kept by Rajendra I in the Shiva temple that he built were a sun pedestal that he took over from Chalukyas, a Ganesh statue and several statues of Durga, a Nandi statue that he took over from Eastern Chalukyas, images of Bhairav and Bhairavi that he took over from Kalinga rulers of Odisha, and a Kali statue from the Palas of Bengal. Now, under the Mughals, the architecture became very complex. So let's discuss elements of Mughal architecture that was used in making gardens, tombs and forts. Now let's talk about gardens first. So Mughals started making Chahar Bagh. So what are Chahar Baghs? These are formal gardens that have almost rectangular shape, and they're symmetrically divided into quarters by artificial channels. Now you can see the picture and the map of Humayun's tomb. The main tomb is surrounded by lots of gardens. All these gardens are having rectangular pattern, and they're symmetrical. Their shape and size is totally equal, and they're separated from each other by artificially constructed walking paths. Now let's discuss some examples of formal gardens under the Mughals. So one we have already discussed, that is Chahar Bagh or Four Gardens, the example of which can be seen in Humayun's tomb in Delhi. And then another example is of Chahar Bagh at Shalimar Gardens in Kashmir. You can see these are also rectangular shaped gardens. This is another picture of Shalimar Gardens. And then another style was of making riverfront garden. In this case, in front of the main structure, there would be a garden, and at the back side of the structure, there would be a river or water body. So one example is of Lal Mahal at Bari, which is in Rajasthan. It was used by kings as a hunting lodge. So as you can see in the map, in front of the main structure, there are Chahar Baghs, and at the back side, there is a water body. Another example of a riverfront garden is of Taj Mahal. If you have visited it, you must be aware that at the back side of Taj Mahal, there is Yamuna River, and in the front side, we can see Chahar Bagh. This is another picture wherein it can be seen at the back side of Yamuna River as well. There are Chahar Baghs where nobles used to live. And this is another picture of Taj Mahal showing the same thing. Now students, let's discuss some elements of Mughal architecture in Humayun's tomb. A tomb is a structure wherein the dead bodies of some important people are buried. So as you can see in the picture, Humayun's tomb is surrounded by Chahar Bagh. Then this structure has a dome at the top. Dome is also called as Gumbad. Then this main structure has an entrance gate, which is also called as Pistak. And you can see the structure is constructed with red sandstone, and on the edges of the sandstone there is white marble. Apart from this, the central hall of this main structure is having 8 rooms, also called as Hasht Behisht or 8 paradises. Thank you so much. Please do not forget to like and subscribe.